Hello, I'm Mr. Anajir, editor, lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist and I come from India, Punjab, where the second coming of Jesus took place. So I can tell you many more things what you can learn from Christianity. So I preach Christianity, Sikhism and real Islam, which is Sharia free. And here I want to tell you the chosen people brought to the promised land under Moses and then now under Christ Jesus. And so this age, dark age, is the time when the priest, rabbis, they become greedy money and they become hypocrite of the first degree. So, the religion is nowhere to be seen. So, most people, they are misled by their fanatic religious preachers or the headmen, rabbis, first, rabbis, all those things, you know. So, here is the simple thing. That this planet Earth is for the habitation of sons of man. Sons of man mean noble people like Adam or Abraham. Abraham was Adam, Sarah was Eve, and Yahweh gave them the promised land as the Garden of Eden. So they are demonstration nation of the world, and we should learn lessons from them. All the moral laws can be learned from them. So then under God is the way of life, which is Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, etc. They are spiritual self and not the physical self. But if you make these one physical over here, then you can't build your covenant with Adam. Then you are born of legitimate parents, but you have changed your tribal identity to Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, etc. They call it Qaum in India, Pakistan. And that is the epicenter of these sons of Satan. So what's happening in Middle East is the same Satan are playing their part. Because very few people are sons of man, tribal people. Most of them have been given the color of religious color. And in this one, the African people and the Brazilian jungle people, they need to be appreciated because their rabbis, the fetish priest, they give them the tribal mark on their faces, which is same as the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac, which is circumcision, which nobody else can have it except the seed of Isaac. But for the sake of money, they were dishing it out to the Gentiles, slaves and everyone, making them sons of Isaac, or by releasing, by changing their tribal identity. They change to new one in Isaac. They become super bastards, fanatic devils, which Jesus described in John 8, verse 44. That parable is very interesting. To him was bring a woman caught in adultery. She would have produced a natural bastard, a mustard seed, who, like prostitutes and temple dancing girls, they produce mustard seeds. And they could become a big saint in devoting their life to the worship of Elohim, Allah, Pabram, our supernatural father. And Krishna, Lord Krishna, who is the who gave us Gita. Gita is the ultimate spiritual knowledge. He was a prophet of Shiva, not of Vishnu. Vishnu was Ramchandra. And he went to a saint called Saint Bidder, who was born of a temple dancing girl, a mustard seed, who had become a big saint. And he went to his small kutia or a hut. He went to his hut and not stayed in the palaces of his relatives, but stayed over there listening to his discourses and discussing with him everything. So the saints are the primary source of light. Prophets are the secondary source of light. So here it is. Situation is very bad in the world, and it is good to know the basic knowledge. It is not difficult. You don't need to go to university to study this thing. It is all, you come through intuition, heart, where God is. This is the sun, Shamas, the middle candle of the menorah. And these are the reflection between this one, body. This is concerning our soul. So these are the six candles of the menorah. And these are the prophet. Moses saw the face of God, but he showed the back to the public. Same, the prophet showed the back to the public through moral laws. So John the Baptist was the last prophet in the promised land. Prophet could be in any land, but in the promised land, John the Baptist was the last one. And he baptized Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, and Christ Jesus in the name of his heavenly father Yahweh. And that seed is to be buried here, to turn it into plant, which is twice born. And then he can bring fruit by entering the narrow gate here into the royal kingdom of God, where your soul is concerned and not your physical body. Physical body here, son of man, created by John the Baptist, to son of God, introduced by Christ Jesus, our Father, through His Word. His Word is God. So, give you an example of His Word, which is very simple. People of tribal people were born under Adam. Tribal people were born, and they went to the temple, became Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian. That is inwardly, not outwardly. And so when they become Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, outwardly as they are today, then they cannot build their covenant to Adam. And when they die, they proclaim that Jew have died, Sikh have died, Hindu have died. These people were not born. Tribal people were born. Tribal people died. So when you say that so many people are Judah tribe, Benjamin, Levi tribe, Hitler killed the tribal people, not Jew, but they had become Jew outwardly, unfaithful to Abraham and Yahweh. And that is why Hitler killed the sinner. Anything concerning flesh is sin. Anything concerning with your heart is blasphemy and very serious. So Hitler was sinner. He killed the sinner who have become Jew outwardly. And Super Hitler Putin is going to kill those who have become unfaithful to Elohim Allah Pabram, our supernatural father who lives in his temple, this one, and going against his will. What is inside should be same as outside, as nothing here was. But hypocrite, they are double. What is inside different, what is outside coming is different. As Tony Blair and Bush said, that Saddam Hussein is a weapon of mass destruction, but none were found there. So they spoke blasphemy. Blasphemy is not forgivable. It is punishable. And that is what they are going to be punished now. Those people who are blasphemed, become Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, Christian, etc., of physical self and not of heart. A Jew is one who is inwardly spiritual, not outwardly physical. This is well stressed by St. Paul. But people read the Bible in the universities and colleges. They read it dead letters. And they do not understand what they mean, anything. If I go there and ask them question, why John the Baptist never baptized a woman, a Gentile or a Samaritan, they have no answer. And I call them super donkeys carrying holy books. And that is what they are, creating all these sectarian riots in the world. So here is something I have written. I will go through and explain. Under Moses, when they returned to their promised land, they were faithful sons of Abraham. And there was no problem entering the promised land. After 6 days, on seventh day, they occupied it. And the land was lush green. They had left as barren. They could not have enough food to eat. When they returned, they found it lush green, welcoming them with the fattened calf, parable of the prodigal son. So today, they have become unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful Yahweh, the same as they were under Abraham. Jacob had 12 sons. Joseph was the only one who was faithful to Abraham and Yahweh. And when he left the promised land, there were none who was faithful to Abraham or Yahweh. So the land became barren. And when Moses made them faithful to Abraham and Yahweh, the same land became lush green. And today they are again unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh. And also there are many, many fake Jew of physical self, not spiritual. And most of them have become like that. So this is common disease all over the world. In India also, you know, in 1947, the people became Hindu and Sikh and Muslim of physical self, and they killed each other. And same thing will happen in Israel today. They will kill each other mercilessly. The tares will burn and kill each other. Sons of man live in peace. I lived in Ghana for 14 years. Over there, the people have tribal mark on their faces. And they live like brethren together. No racism. They love each other. If you give them one to one of them something to eat, he will call everyone, come, let's share. All will bite out of that one. So that is their sense of brotherhood. So this planet Earth is for the habitation of the sons of Adam or sons of Abraham. That is why 144,000 they are mentioned by their tribes and not as Jews. So Jews, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, they cannot occupy the land, because land belong to Adam and his sons. So you will see how people will die and kill each other all over the world. And what you are seeing today is nothing strange. And you can easily understand how the fake, or how these saltless people are gathered together in Israel for final burning. So, no justice, nothing like that. I have written something that would make easy to understand, but if somebody wants a thorough understanding, I am ready to give you detailed lectures on this one. And on Skype, we can talk with each other. If you have three or four gathered together, then I can explain everything to them, and they can ask me questions and I can answer them. So, doing like this one, I tried my best. So, bring back the chosen people under Moses, faithful to Abraham and Yahweh, and under Christ, unfaithful to Abraham and Yahweh, the tares, sons of the Satan, under Moses. Out of the 12 sons of Jacob, only Joseph was salt of Abraham and Yahweh, whilst the other 11 were liars and murderers. On the sale of Joseph as a slave to the Egyptians, the promised land became barren, as none of them left behind was faithful to Abraham and Yahweh. Yahweh stopped rain, and they were kicked out of the promised land by Abraham, the father of the faithful sons only. Today, you know, they have this in Hebron, they have Hebron, they have the grave of Abraham, and there are two windows, they are going to pray there. But praying there to whom? They are not the sons of Abraham. They are Hamas and Fatah and Jews, and that they can't build their covenant with Abraham. They are the tares, so they are useless. Joseph was very much honored by the Egyptians, and he rose to the highest position, the prime minister of the country. Joseph, possessing the salt of Abraham, displayed forgetfulness. So he forget his brethren, what they did to him, and of the past treatment which his brethren, crook brethren, had done to him, and got them the best land to settle in Egypt. But the crook remained crooks, and the local noble people of Ishmael, ever faithful sons of Abraham, made them slaves, or the saltless people were not worth the manure in the field. And the Pharaohs became cruel to them, as Hitler did recently. So Hitler did recently because again they were showing those ugly habits. Moses brought the Sukkot. Sukkot are those people who are thrown out of their home, are the sons of Abraham who were thrown out from the promised land. Sukkot, sons of Abraham, back as the faithful sons, and the same land became lush green for the rightful owners to live. So after 6 days, you know, on seventh day they enter the promised land. Seventh day, the judgment day, middle candle of the menorah. This story is told by Christ Jesus in the parable of the prodigal son, Isaac, who was kicked out of the promised land by Abraham, while the elder son, Ishmael, remained faithful but not enjoying the fruit of the earth as the real sons, as the real son of Abraham. Old habits die hard, and they return to their old habits of cheating the Goyeishi Koppa Gentile who came to visit the holiest of the holy temple. Goyeishi Koppa Gentile who came to visit the holiest of the holy complex in Jerusalem. Now today this the holiest of holy complex is in Amritsar. In the whole world, nothing better, nothing holier than that. But the it is in the hands of the crook kings and emperors of darkness, people of the Khatri tribe, worse than those of the Judah tribe. And they are cheating people very much. You get nothing out of it. Their rabbis created a wall in the middle temple of Yahweh, putting their chosen people with gadgets all on this one, on the head and everything, around their arms and well-dressed in front. And the Gentiles behind the wall became proud, racist. That's why Jesus cured 10 lepers. 9 of them were Jewish people. And as soon as they were cured, they went back to their rabbi and very were eager to sit in front of the temple. And they forgot Jesus altogether. And one Samaritan, when he was cured, he returned back and joined hands with him. But Jesus said, your rabbis, they are efficient. They are not crook like the Jewish rabbis. You go back and to your own people and enjoy your family life. You don't need Christ. Christ was needed by the spiritually sick people and they killed him. If any Gentile wants to sit in front, they will ask him to first become their disciples, in which they circumcise the Gentile, changing their tribal father to Isaac of the Semitic race. If an Aryan Gentile comes, there are black Negro Gentiles come there and become the one to sit in front, yeah, no problem. Get yourself circumcised or become the son of the Semitic Isaac. You know, this circumcision is the tribal mark of Abraham to Isaac. So they will circumcise the person and change his tribal identity to the Semitic race of Isaac. Then you can't change it. You become, by renouncing your own father, you become super bastards. That's why Jesus told them in the temple. I will come to that one. The rabbi must become the disciple in which they circumcise the Gentile, changing their tribal father to Isaac of the Semitic race. As you know, you cannot change your tribal father or race and caste. In Ghana, you know, where I lived, people have tribal mark on their faces. And I asked them, could anybody else have that tribal mark? No. Only people of that tribe have that tribal mark. So that means you can't change it. They had such a knowledge, but not these people. So the greedy rabbis created such fake sons of Isaac and called them Jews outwardly, whereas a Jew is one who is inwardly spiritual and not outwardly tribal. So the circumcised and called them Jews outwardly. So such Sukkot, natural bastard born of a prostitute or adultery, the mustard seeds, to the religious fanatic such as Jew, Hindu, Sikh, Muslim, etc., outwardly, instead of the tribal people to inhabit the planet Earth, as stressed in the Revelation 144,000 tribal people, 12,000 are Judah tribe, Benjamin, so and so, and not Jews would be saved. So they are tares bundled in Israel for final burning. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30 is getting fulfilled. They will burn and kill each other. Under Christ Jesus, the clever, greedy rabbis made so many Gentiles and slaves, the fake sons of Isaac, through circumcision, that Christ Jesus, the first anointed Christ in the world, had to take a virgin birth among the most greedy and clever people of the Judah tribe. I have written an article on this and I put it here, you know. Oh, yeah. Now, the gospel cannot be preached to the sons of Most High Satan Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa, those who are not sons of their tribal father. The gospel cannot be preached because from tribal father to become sons of the Most High, Elohim Allah Abraham. That's why St. Thomas went to South India, where there were tribal people, and he changed them to become the sons of the Most High, Elohim Allah Abraham, the Christ, not Christian. Christians are people of the book. They don't know their tribal father, most of them. Now the gospel cannot be preached to the sons of Most High Satan Al-Jamar Al-Aqsa, but to the faithful tribal people. In the temple, the rabbis, priests, professors of theology were so arrogant and full of ego, they would not listen to the sensible people like Simeon in the temple. Remember Simeon, he tried to dissuade them, you know, to not to have malpractices, but they didn't mind him. And that is why Simeon was waiting for Christ Jesus to appear before he dies. The rabbis, under the influence of the temple high priest, were making the people, Jews, outwardly unfaithful to Abraham and Yahweh. If they are unfaithful to Abraham and Yahweh, how can they live in the promised land then? No way. This man of the dead letters, Church Father Origen, tried to build the covenant of the Jews with Abraham but failed. He said up to Isaac he can go, from Isaac to Abraham he can't go. And he was taking Jew as physical self, not spiritual, not understanding St. Paul. A Jew is one who is inwardly, not outwardly. That is the knowledge they have in the churches. They are dead in letters. You try to do the same, and it is a basic test of spirituality. If you can do it, then let me know. That is why God sent Prophet Elijah in the name of Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, same thing, the Demiurge, the cornerstone of the temple of Yahweh, John the Baptist, first to make the people faithful to Abraham or turn them faithful to their tribal fathers. This was done 6 months before the conception of Mary, Yeshua, with Christ in his heart, to preach the gospel to the sons of man. Remember, these 6 months are very important, because this atomic war is going to take place after 14th November 2023, which is 6 months after Israel is 75 years old. So let's see what happened in November. This was done as per the manure, in which the six candles are of Yahweh and the middle seventh candle called Shamash, Sun, the Christ, to enlighten the sons of Abraham, created by John the Baptist. So John the Baptist was baptizing Jewish men in water in the name of Abraham, and then Jesus was turning them into sons of God. We are baptizing in the name of Abraham. Jesus baptized in the name of his heavenly father Yahweh. That's why his name was Yeshua. And that ego is to be buried to go into the royal kingdom. Take no money in your pocket, no two shoes, no two tunic, and no script. Scripture is forbidden. In Bible is forbidden here. So scripture finished up to John the Baptist. That is Luke 16, verse 16. Law and prophet were till John the Baptist. Transgression against the scripture is sin. So sin finished by John the Baptist. In Christ Jesus, we have blasphemy. And we expose that through his word by explaining the basic principle. Let's carry on. This was done as per the menorah, in which the sixth candle are of Yahweh and the middle seventh candle called Shamash, Sun, the primary source, the Christ, to enlighten the sons of Abraham, the tribal people, created by John the Baptist. Very few people turned to John the Baptist, while most of them remained Jews of the flesh, arrogant, you know, the super bastard, fanatic devils. John 8, verse 44. Because the temple priest, they will hate those people who call themselves that they belong to Judah tribe, Benjamin, or Levi tribe. As if I go to a Gurdwara and I tell them that my tribe is Jat, they will hate me. They will say, in Sikhism there is no caste. So such thing they will tell you, you know. Same thing in the Judah tribe and in the temple, you know, in the Jewish temple, no tribe. And making them super bastard. This is well reflected in the trial of Jesus. There were hardly few who spoke in favor of Christ Jesus, but majority against. So their voice was stifled down. The just King Pilate washed his hands under sun and handed Jesus over to the temple priests to treat their king according to their customs. The tares beat Jesus mercilessly and crucified him for no fault. From such tears, the temple was taken away, and they were thrown out of the promised land in 70 AD. Today, they are back in the promised land for the final burning, Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. And they must show their colors before the atomic war expected soon after 14 November 2023, when Israel is supposed to attack Iran, full of the fake sons of Isaac, circumcised. You remember, they are Aryan, but they are circumcised. Through circumcision, they become the fake sons of Isaac. And so that's what they are going to kill the other people, you know. Fake sons of Isaac circumcised when the Jewish people became mullahs in the mosque. When they became mullahs in the mosque under Muhammad Sahib, Hazrat Muhammad, they bring in the circumcision and also the kosher halal, kosher they call it halal. Much more in my other videos. YouTube does not like my gospel truth videos and delete them with a strike. Any help anybody can offer, it will be much appreciated. So gospel is as easy as ABC. You don't need any going to any university to study theology. It's all here, simple. Tribal people are born, tribal people will die, not Hindu, Sikh or Muslim. My father told this thing to 2,000 people coming to attack our village. Fortunately, headman of the village, headman of the attacking party was friend of my uncle who was the headman of the village. And so my father and uncle went to see him. And when my father told them that Hindu, Sikh or Muslim, they are spiritual selves. They are never born, they never die. We tribal people are going to kill each other. If we have any enmity against our tribe, let us settle it now. Very good condition. He said, no, we are friends. So he told the 2,000 people to look after us as their guest, which they did. That is how the sons of man live, together peacefully. Whichever tribe you are, doesn't matter. You enjoy your peace in Khuda, Yahweh and Brahma. They are the deviant gods. Our Father God blesses everyone in agape, unconditional divine love.